A person going to a party was asked to bring 3 different bags of chips. Going to the store, she finds 12 varieties. How many different selections can she make? So there are 12 varieties of chips at the store, and she's taking 3 of them at a time. Whenever we have a situation like this where we have n items, in this case 12 varieties, and we're taking r at a time, in this case 3 at a time, the first question should be, does the order matter? If the order matters, then we'll use a permutation to determine the total number of ways this can be done. If the order doesn't matter, we use a combination. So let's say we have one bag of each variety shown here. If we select 3 different bags, let's say these first 3 bags, the question is, if we change the order of these 3 bags, does it change the selection? And the answer is no. If we change the order here, it's still the same 3 types of chips, which means to find how many different selections she can make, we use a combination. So we want to find the combinations of 12 items, or 12 varieties, selected 3 at a time. So we have 12 choose 3. Notice n equals 12 and r equals 3. So to evaluate this by hand, we would have n factorial, which is 12 factorial, divided by n minus r factorial, that would be 12 minus 3 factorial, times r factorial, which is 3 factorial. So simplifying, we have 12 factorial divided by 9 factorial times 3 factorial. To simplify this, we'll start to expand 12 factorial, but because there's a 9 factorial in the denominator, we'll write 12 factorial as 12 times 11 times 10, then we'll write times 9 factorial. Then we have divided by 9 factorial times 3 factorial. Notice this makes it much easier to simplify. 9 factorial over 9 factorial simplifies to 1. And now we're left with 12 times 11 times 10 divided by 3 factorial, which is 3 times 2 times 1. And now we'll simplify again. Notice 12 and 3 share a common factor of 3. There's 1 3 and 3 and 4 3s and 12. And now 4 and 2 share a common factor of 2. There's 1 2 and 2 and 2 2s and 4. So we're left with 2 times 11 times 10, which equals 220. So there are 220 different selections. But before we go, I also want to show how we can find this combination on the graphing calculator. And the graphing calculator uses this notation here. So we first enter n, which is 12, press math, right arrow to probability, and notice that combination is option 3. So we can press 3, or go down and highlight 3 and then press enter. I'm just going to press 3, and now we enter r, which is 3, then enter. Notice how this does verify our work by hand is correct. I hope you found this helpful.